If you had the option to know the truth, the whole truth and nothing but the truth regarding everything in the universe's existence, would you want to know, and what would you want to know first? I think about one of the conversations Jordan Peterson had on Joe Rogan's podcast. They were talking about Nietzsche, and when he wrote his famous line, "God is dead," people always took that as an aggressive stance that religion doesn't exist and whatnot. Jordan Peterson stated that it's actually the other way around, that Nietzsche was genuinely sad and not trying to provoke. Nietzsche saw how the world was and where it was headed and told himself, if there is or was a God, he isn't with us anymore. We're on a ship with no captain at the helm. Now I'm not the religious type, but that stuck with me. Whatever the afterlife is, the real truth could be that there's actually nothing special waiting for us. I want to know why almost half the tall posts on this sub are always horndog material. I mean, I guess some of those questions might be thought-provoking for some people, but most of them are just very common questions. In fact, aren't these posts what are AskReddit After Dark is for? But this is Reddit. I think I already know the answer to this. I read their books about the houses Atreides, Harkonnen and Corino. Nice background info about the families. Once the Atreides were like the Harkonnen and vice versa, or does that come from McNally's Dune Encyclopedia? Some sparse interesting ideas. The giant spaceships are built underground, because once finished, they can fall to space. Obvious after you read it, but I was pleasantly surprised. But I agree, they don't even touch their father's heels. As far as I know, they're milking Frank's notes, so the good stuff could be stolen from those and put in their books as their own. Wouldn't surprise me if they did. Happiness is not a feeling, it is more of a state of mind. He who expects too much will be disappointed, yet he who expects too little will never be satisfied. Everything in the physical life is temporary, and the one thing we can control is how we experience it. Happiness comes from within, and it is like a plant that must be watered and catered. I don't want to know everything regarding the absolute truths of the universe. To paraphrase Exer Buane, he put on the glasses and saw everything, the logic at the bottom of physics and the madness at the top. Basically, I think I would go insane if given the knowledge of everything in the universe and how it all works. It's just too much for a human mind to comprehend and maintain proper function. I wouldn't want to know. Could you imagine having that knowledge and being unable to convince others of its authenticity? Watching every error being made, knowing beforehand it was an error and the bad things that will happen because of it. Like watching your kid making a mistake that will cause them pain, but also knowing that it's a mistake they have to make on their own. No thank you. A circle becomes aware it is a circle. It knows what a circle is, specifically and absolutely, along with what makes it different from other shapes, along with commonalities it shares as well. Does it continue to exist as a circle knowing that everything it means to be a circle laid in front of it? Does it try to be another shape, a square, perhaps a triangle? Does it transcend completely to a non-shape, whereas understanding of all knowledge would lead to all potential outcomes of all applied actions? It would also constrain a seemingly infinitely capable being to a set and setting with all known outcomes deterministic. There are worse fates than death. I thought black holes were little holes for the longest time. From my understanding, they're really, really dense dead stars that have so much gravity that light cannot escape, therefore it appears to be a hole. So if you fly into it, you don't teleport or anything, you're just obliterated. Like, what would happen if you flew into any other star? Number. A black hole is a super dense mass with an unimaginably strong gravitational field, not a hole in the universe. Honestly, I doubt that there are any unique traits to black holes related to time or space. It's just that they're unobservable due to their own gravitational field. If you were to fly a probe into a black hole, I don't think the probe would be sent off through a wormhole or anything like that. I think it would become unobservable and be crushed into nothing. I'd like to know what the future of Earth, humanity holds, as well as what other planets are out there with life or civilizations. What kind of amazing forests are out there and what are other alien civilizations like? I bet there's planets out there with perfect circles of life, with pristine nature and wildlife everywhere, like Earth was in humanity's early days before humans trashed this planet. Man, I feel for you. Something similar happened to my wife in 2019. Mom suddenly died of a heart attack, dad dating next week and married within 3 months. The lady he married was there during the heart attack and allegedly tried to revive her. My wife and her mom knew this lady before the attack. They did not like her at all because of how abusive she was to her previous husband. My Phil justified marrying this lady using religious bullshit, something like I prayed about it and I know that she would want me to move on. My wife says no, not with this lady. How my dad really died. Sure, it was a heart attack, but he was taking pills, and stopped them, for that, and he wanted to divorce my mom, because she's a boss. And her reply was, you can have them in hell. Shortly after, whoopsie, he died in his sleep while she slept on the couch. How weird that he wasn't taking any of his pills either. How odd that my mom never spoke of him afterwards except to celebrate the day he died. How interesting that my entire family shunned my mom afterwards and had a rumor that she murdered him for his 401k that she received after he died. How intriguing that she got with someone else less than a week after my dad's funeral. Oh, and he was cremated, so there's no chance to look at his body for evidence, and as it so happens, she lost all his ashes despite them being kept in the same spot for years. Guess they grew feet and hobbled away to our wood stove sash pile. Seriously, there's just too many weird fucking things surrounding that for me to be comfortable with. This is a pretty cool question, like what if we tried to apply the same evolution theories to the universe itself? If the universe's creation and destruction is cyclical, could it evolve at some point? Maybe changing small things here and there, which become cosmic changes when it expands, just to be able to last a few extra trillion years over this iteration, or maybe it's always exactly the same. So I'm bound to write this exact comment in the next iteration, fun thought haha. Well wait. If there was nothing at any point in time, then the origin, start of the universe would have never happened, because something would have had to exist in order for something to start the beginning. This must mean that there has always been something, even before existence as we know it started. This same bundle of thoughts first came to me when I was lying in bed in the 6th grade. It was the second time my mind was truly blown out the back of my skull. The first was when I was 4 and realized I was alive, controlling my body, etc. Anyway, that night in the 6th grade was terrifying to me. I was raised Christian and never questioned it up to that point, but that was definitely the first time I was like, wait. The why is there existence rather than nothing question is the one that fucks with me the hardest somehow. I try to imagine if there truly were nothing, which is an impossible thing to even fathom for a second. Then I think, well, there has to be something, or else there would be nothing. But if there were nothing, ever, then nothing. There is only something because there has to be, and then I basically have a miniature heart attack and try to fall asleep. It definitely didn't improve once I started doing psychedelic drugs, lol. I'm reminded of Neil deGrasse Tyson's standard answer whenever someone asks him a question along the lines of, if you could know anything, what would it be? He talks about his almost existential fear that however advanced our technology and means of observation might become, that the human being, the meat inside our skull, lacks the capability to understand everything, that even if we could somehow be presented with a fact sheet containing every fact about the universe, some of those facts would be permanently out of reach for our understanding. So his answer to the question would be, Is it possible for humans to even understand everything? That would be first question. Rather than risk asking what is time? And be gifted the answer beyond my understanding, and driven to some kind of Lovecraftian madness. I had a mushroom trip that was this exact story. I thought I was in purgatory waiting to be reborn again while I was laying on my roommate's bed next to her. I asked her for help to go to the bathroom because I was too messed up to get up. She told me, SHHHH, it doesn't matter. I thought, oh right, cause we're dead, in purgatory and waiting to be reborn and full on pissed her bed. As I was waiting to see the light on the other side of the birth canal, my roommate became suddenly concerned as the pee seeped over to her side of the bed. Really messed up my zen. Cockroaches get a pretty good deal. They don't have to pay taxes, don't have credit scores, and don't have to do much of anything other than eat and fuck. If worst comes to worst, those MFS can survive a nuclear strike too. I'd be pretty pissed if someone crushed me as a cockroach and I was reborn as a woman in Afghanistan. Well, what happened when you were born, dude? An infinite amount of time passes that you're totally you aware of, and then with no memory of what happened prior, you pop into existence. When you die, the only next thing that can happen is you're born again. From your perspective, this takes no time, but it might be infinite time. But still, anyway, that's why you should be nice to people and not step on cockroaches, because they are you. All the different lives you can live and be born as, they are all you, and the foot squashing you is you too. Alright, but I like to imagine that the perception of time slows down and you just have a dream of another life. Turns out when you die in that life, you slow down perception and have another life. I am the only real person here. Of course, this probably isn't true, and I really hope it isn't. The idea that I am the only truly conscious person terrifies me. My current conception is definitely the worst. Frozen consciousness. Wherever you are, you freeze in time. Death by stab wound, you're gonna feel it forever. All time stops and you experience your last moment of consciousness as it drags out into eternity. Good luck to anyone who dies in their sleep. Alternatively, the best option, infinite reincarnation. It turns out our outside has a point. Life is a game, customizable characters and all. But you don't know you're playing it. The game never ends, but the single round takes a full lifetime. You only have memories created since the last round you started. Nothing is not the worst option, not by a long shot. What if you stay conscious, trapped in a stinking, rotting corpse for all eternity? What if you go to wherever you believe you go? What if one specific religion is right? Knowing me, I wouldn't change anything till the last moment. But, well, if I was certain about this info and the source, host a big ass party a few days prior to the death date, write last will to distribute stuff accumulated during life, including organs that will survive the party. Live stream the last day with all appropriate warnings for those who wouldn't want to see someone dropping dead. I'm not really into destructive parties, so 98% that all the organs will survive this. However, knowing the date without knowing what comes next, the original topic we discussed here, is still somewhat depressing. Doesn't matter if next stage is a simple log out from our outside heaven. Hell, a void of nothingness or something else, would be nice to know in advance. Smile. Edit 1. Markdown. Are you sure? The universe is expanding at 67.4 kilometers per second per megaparsec. The speed of light is 300,000 kilometers per second. This means for an object to be moving away from you faster than light, it would need to be 300,067.4 equals 4,451 megaparsecs away. A megaparsec is a million parsecs, which is about 3 million light years, so only objects more than about 4,500 times 3 million equals 13.5 billion light years away from us are moving away faster than C. That's much further away than the local group. I mean, unless I've done the maths wrong. Edit. I think this confusion may stem from a Kurzgesagt video from a few years ago. Some people pointed out that this video wasn't correct, but it seems people didn't want to hear it. It wasn't until nearly 5 years later that the channel posted a corrected video and admitted that the old video made claims that weren't actually true. In that space of time, the incorrect video got 17 million views. So of course by that point the misinformation had spread far and wide. Rather than removing the incorrect video, they kept it up and just renamed it. Doesn't look like they actually edited anything else on that video, for example the description, to explain what the problem was. We will never see them. We are lucky that our gravity cluster contains two large galaxies and many dwarf galaxies. All the rest are moving away from us faster than the speed of light. We will never go there. We are lucky to live in a time where we can even see them, as at some point they will all have moved so far away no trace of them will be visible to us. 2 trillion galaxies in the known universe, each with 100 million stars, would be really weird if there wasn't at least as advanced as us. The only problem is getting around in our own galaxy is unfathomable in itself. Intelligent life could be in another galaxy so far away from us you might not even count it as the same existence. I love Hitchhiker's Guide so much, and the movie has a special place in my heart, because I convinced a bunch of friends to come see this movie with me on release weekend, but I was the only one who read the book. And at the end of the opening song "So Long and Thanks for All the Fish My Friends," it was like a whole row at the theater thought this movie was so preposterous that they all got up and left. Ha 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 ha, they're not my friends anymore, uncultured swine. No. You were absolutely right on almost all accounts. There was a 1980 series, later cut into feature length, made by the BBC, and there's the 2005 Hollywood adaptation. The book I have is literally called the compounded five-part trilogy on the back. It's the edition where all books were made into a single one. It's kinda long, but you're laughing from start to finish. One of my all-time favorite English books ever. There is a scene in one of the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy's sequel books where they call an individual to the stand in court and give him a truth serum, but give him way too much. They ask him to tell the truth, the whole truth and nothing but the truth. It cuts to later and everyone in the courtroom has gone insane or killed themselves, and he is just sitting after divulging the truth, the whole truth and nothing but the truth, laughing his ass off about the hidden reality of frogs. Nothing will ever change again and time will cease to exist. Well, some physicists say that the act of time ceasing to exist means the universe has equal entropy everywhere. Do you know what else has equal entropy everywhere? The conditions for the Big Bang. Of course, this involves deep time. You're not waiting for the stars to burn out, you're waiting for every star and every atom to decay into iron, then that iron to collapse into black holes, then those black holes to decay into Hawking radiation, then that radiation to stretch itself so far that its wavelength becomes smaller than the Planck length. Only then can a new universe be born. The theory now, as I understand it, is all the energy in the universe will eventually end up as heat and basically peter out onto the vastness of the universe. The stars will explode and reform, but will in turn burn out and die one by one until the last one dies and decays. Then when that has happened, nothing will ever change again and time will cease to exist. It was all for nothing. I am available for children's birthdays parties if you want to book me in. The Big Crunch Theory, gravity pulling everything from the Big Bang back and resulting in another singularity that repeats itself, has fallen out of favor, but you're right in that it still does explain the beginning. This one messes with my head so much trying to think about it. I want to say we were completely different universe that collapsed into a black hole that got overloaded and exploded, aka Big Bang. But then it's like, where did that universe come from? Have we been going through this infinite loop for all of time? That's where my brain stops comprehending. Like, everything in our universe has a beginning and end, or so we think. That's the way our own brains think of everything. So to think of something that simply exists with no beginning or end, the matter in the universe, is mind-boggling.